is converting into mechanical energy. So engines are two types. Those are internal combustion engine and external combustion engine. So internal combustion engine, 1 minute. Excuse me, 1 minute. So see here, first of all, external combustion engine, in that name itself, combustion will be takes place in external places. So let us take boiler. Boiler is, it is one of the, okay, I'll explain in this figure. So this is the combustion chamber, where this is the combustion chamber. Next, above that water is there. That water will be heat by utilizing this material, whatever it may be, a coal or any substance. Okay, that water will vapors, and that vapor is utilizing for the movement of this piston. See here, this steam will move towards the cylinder. Okay, that cylinder, when the vapor moves to the cylinder, this piston will move towards downward direction. Okay, so whereas in internal combustion engine, so in internal combustion engine, combustion will be takes place in internal places. It means this is the air fuel mixture or any substance will be combusted at this place, and it will, here combustion will be takes place and it causes the movement of piston towards downward direction, and then after it will moves to upward direction. I'll explain this in this figure. See here, total in our engine, 4 strokes are there. Those are suction stroke, compression stroke, power stroke and exhaust stroke. All are seeing this cursor. Sir, mic, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, continue.
Sir, is it visible? Cursor is visible.
Yeah, visible.
Okay. So here, this is the inlet. Okay. Next, whenever the air fuel mixture is enter into the inlet, this inlet valve will be open. Okay. Air fuel mixture will be enter into this chamber. Okay. Then after, during the suction stroke, entire this piston will move towards the downward direction. So at that time, air fuel mixture will be enter into the cylinder. Then after, this piston will move to upward direction. See here, in this second stroke, this is the compression stroke. See the direction of arrow. Okay, this piston will move towards the upward direction. Then the particle, so here particles are visible now. This particle density will be increased, so automatically compression will be takes place. It causes the higher whenever the compression takes place, the spark plug will be ignite a small spark, then the entire air mixture in the cylinder will burn. Then after, the entire energy will absorb by the piston. This piston will move towards the downward direction by using connecting rod. This is the connecting rod. Then after, this entire energy will move towards the crankshaft. So this is the crankshaft. Okay, next, after completion of power stroke, exhaust, some of the gases, burn gases, those burn gases may be remaining in this cylinder, and those gases are moved towards the outside in the exhaust stroke. Before that, I want to explain about external combustion engine. Here thermal efficiency is very less, 15 to 20% only. Why? Because combustion is stage plus external place, na. So the power transmission from one place to another place, at that time maybe most of the losses are occur. So here thermal efficiency is very less. Whereas in internal combustion engine, here thermal efficiency is 40%. Okay. Then classification of combustion engines. So classifications are engines are classified into so many parts. Those are four-stroke cycle engine and two-stroke cycle engine. So four-stroke cycle engine, here is suction, compression, power, and exhaust. Suction, at the time already explained, na. In suction stroke, air fuel mixture will be entered into the cylinder. Then after, during the compression, entire air fuel mixture will be compressed, and then in at the end of compression, power stroke will be occur. At that power stroke, the power will be moved towards the downward piston will move towards downward direction. Then during the exhaust stroke, entire gases which are available in the cylinder will move outside. Okay, in two-stroke cycle engine. So major difference between the four-stroke cycle engines are entire four strokes are completed in two revolution of crankshaft, that is four stroke. Whereas entire four strokes, suction, compression, power, and exhaust, these all are complete one complete rotation of crankshaft. If we want to complete one complete rotation of crankshaft, we need to provide at least two strokes, that is TDC to BDC one and BDC to TDC another one. So whereas in four stroke engine, it requires four strokes. Four stroke is nothing but two complete revolution of crankshafts. Okay, see here, first of all observe this second picture. So during the first stroke, air fuel mixture will be enter, and as well as this piston moves towards the upward direction. So as like this, here suction, during the suction time, air fuel mixture will be entered into the chamber, as well as compression also takes place during the single stroke itself. After completion of first stroke, this spark plug will ignite a small spark, then the air fuel mixture will be burned. It causes the movement of piston towards downward direction. See here, when this piston moves towards downward direction, the energy which are liberated in this cylinder will transmitted to crankshaft by using piston, connecting rod, and crankshaft. One end of the crankshaft will have a flywheel, so entire energy will be stored in flywheel, and remaining, if any excess amount of gas is available or if any excess energy is available in the cylinder, that will move towards the exhaust ports. And one more thing is, major difference in four stroke and two stroke is, here valves are there. This is the inlet valve, and whereas this is the outlet valve. Whereas in two stroke, we don't have any valves, just these are the ports, POTS ports. Okay, so major difference between two stroke and four stroke in the inlet and outlet are, in four stroke inlet and outlets are the valves, whereas in two stroke ports. These are the, this is the inlet port and this outlet port. Okay, and according to number of cylinders, so most of our tractors or any cars or any others, all are multi-cylinder. See, this is the multi-cylinder engine. Whereas monoblock pumps, most of the people may saw in command areas. It means most of the people, these are utilizing for pumping the water from lower elevation to higher elevation in fields, whereas in canal irrigated fields. So here, this is, it will have only single cylinder. So this is called single cylinder engine or monoblock cylinder engine. Okay. Okay. Next, multi-cylinder engine. So here number of cylinders are 4. See, this is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Depending upon number of cylinders, this classification is also classified. So let us take. Already I told 4 strokes: suction, compression, power, and exhaust. Here you are observing firing order. Firing order is nothing but power stroke will occur only in one cylinder. Then after, it means we have 4 strokes: suction, compression, power, and exhaust. Let us take here power stroke is in first cylinder. Power stroke is occurred. Then next stroke, second or third or fourth, whatever, in that only one cylinder will get power stroke, and remaining 3 we have, one will be suction stroke, another will be exhaust, another will be compression. Okay, so firing order is nothing but, let us take first cylinder having power stroke, then it will be first firing order, first cylinder having power stroke, next fourth cylinder we have firing order. So 1, 4, next 2, 3, that is the firing order. It means in first cylinder power stroke is occurred, then fourth cylinder, and it means stroke in fourth cylinder if power stroke is occurred, 1, 4, 2, 3, that is the firing order. Okay, compared to, next, according to cylinder arrangement, horizontal cylinder engine and vertical cylinder engine. It means most of monoblock engines. Most of the monoblock engines, already I told na. This is the monoblock engine. Here, piston will be placed in horizontal direction, whereas here piston is placed in vertical direction. So major difference is according to cylinder arrangement, horizontal cylinder arrangement and vertical cylinder arrangement. So next, according to engine speed, most of the important bit. So low speed engine and high speed engine. If the crankshaft speed, already I told, one complete revolution of crankshaft is completed within 2 strokes. That is 2-stroke engine. Complete revolution of crankshaft is completed in 2 strokes for getting single power stroke. That is 4-stroke. So here low speed engine. So here 100 RPM. It means if it is 2-stroke engine, it requires 200 complete strokes for completion of 100 RPM of crankshaft. Okay, if crankshaft rotates 100 RPM, that is low speed engine. Whereas 250 RPM, more than 250 RPM is high speed engine. Okay, this is according to engine speed. I think most
Harsha, unmute yourself. Harsha, unmute yourself. Harsha? Harsha, unmute chesko. Nene ante vere daggara sound vastundi, mute all chesanu.
Okay, sir, okay. So I think this is completed. Next, according to cooling system, most of the person, I think all the persons saw this type of engine in bikes. So main aim of this fins, these are called fins, main aim of these fins are to increase the contact surface area. Okay, why we need to increase the contact surface area? If entire thing is cowling with a plain sheet, we will have very lesser contact area. Whenever we are going with the higher velocity, air will contact this cowling. So if it is plain, there will be very less contact area. So temperature, almost engine temperature will be around 1600 degree centigrade. So to reduce the temperature, we are providing the highest contact surface area. So whenever the cool air touches these fins, automatically this heat will be reduced from higher level to lower level. So here main aim of fins are to increase the contact surface area of engine, whereas in water cooled engine, so in water cooled engine, most of the all are having water jackets. I think most of the people saw in tractors and lorries. Okay, we are pouring water into the radiator, so those water is utilizing for cooling the engine temperature. So radiator, whatever water are placed in the radiator, that will move towards the engine jackets. So whenever engine is heated, that water will be circulate towards the jackets, that heat will be liberated by the water. So automatically that entire heat will be absorbed by water, that water will move towards the top portion of radiator. Cool water will move towards jackets from the bottom part of the radiator. Okay, see, these are the different parts of the engines. So first of all, so here this is the piston. Okay, this is the connecting rod. So piston and connecting rod is connected with the piston pin. One more thing here, piston pin also called as wrist pin and guardian pin. Okay, so one more thing here grooves are there, three grooves will be there. Here first two grooves are fixed with the compression rings, and last ring is oil ring. So main aim of the compression ring and oil ring is whenever this piston move towards the cylinder block. So here this is the cylinder block, so there should not be any thrust. Okay, there should, so entire piston will move towards this cylinder block, whereas in oil ring is to scrap the oil which are available here. So entire oil will scrap towards the sump. Okay, so one more, next, this is the crankshaft. So first of all, piston pin, connecting rod, crankshaft, flywheel. One end of the crankshaft is fixed with the flywheel. One more thing is, flywheel is a main energy source of an engine. So one here only we are getting power is getting only in one stroke, that is in power stroke, whereas in suction, compression and exhaust strokes, we are not getting any power. Okay, so whatever energy generated in the power stroke, that is absorbed by the piston, from piston to connecting rod, from connecting rod to crankshaft, from crankshaft to entire energy will be absorbed by the flywheel. During the idle strokes, which are suction, compression and exhaust, these absorbed energy, which is absorbed by the flywheel, it will operate the remaining three idle strokes. So next, here crank gear. Next, it is connected with the cam gear. Here, this is the camshaft. One end of the camshaft, cam gear will be there. Okay, that cam gear will, here this power will transmitted to the cam gear. It causes the rotation of camshaft. Camshaft is utilized for operating the inlet and outlet valves. Okay, inlet and outlet valves are operated with camshaft. Okay, and one more thing here is cam gear is half time gear. Number of teeth in the crank gear is half of the number of teeth in the cam gear. It means if 10 teeth are available in the cam gear, crank gear, in cam gear multiplication of 2, it means 10 into 2, 20 teeth will be available. So that's why it is called as half time gear. Okay, so engine components. So main components are cylinder. So
hello, excuse me sir.
Sorry. Okay
sir, can you explain the previous point sir, the teeth number sir, one second please sir.
Okay here, so one more thing I'll come with from first. So this is the piston. Okay na? Okay, from piston entire energy will transmitted to crankshaft by utilizing the connecting rod. Okay, from connecting rod energy will transmitted to flywheel. Okay, and one end of the crankshaft will have flywheel and another end will have gear, crank gear. Okay, number of teeth in the crank gear, let us take x. Okay, it is connected with the cam gear. Here this is the camshaft, one end of the camshaft will have cam gear. So here number of teeth in the cam gear is 2 into x. So here let us take here 12, then the teeth in the cam gear is 2 into 12, that is 24. So for completion of one revolution of camshaft, it required to rotate 2 times of crankshaft. It means after completion of 2 complete revolution of crankshaft, camshaft will rotate only single time. Okay, why? Because number of teeth in the cam gear is double compared with the crank gear. That's why only we are calling this cam gear as half time gear. Okay, is it clear?
Can I explain? Okay sir, clear time? Sir no sir, no need sir.
Only okay, major difference between the crank gear and cam gear is number of teeth in the crank gear is half of teeth in the cam gear. Okay, so next, engine components. So cylinder, see here, this is the cylinder. So entire piston will move towards the cylinder. Okay, so major aim of the cylinder is combustion space, and whatever air fuel mixture is enter into the cylinder, that should be combust. It means whenever this, during the suction stroke, air fuel mixture will be placed into the cylinder. During the compression stroke, entire space will be reduced into smaller area, so automatically pressure will be increased. At that time spark plug will ignite a small fire. Okay, then the air fuel mixture will be combust due to the small fire. Okay, next, that power is, whatever power is generated in the cylinder, that is transmitted towards the piston, from piston to connecting rod, connecting rod to crankshaft, and crankshaft to flywheel. Here major aim is, major purpose of cylinder is to combust the air fuel mixture, and it is made with the high grade cast iron. Why we are utilizing the high grade cast iron? So already I told, engine temperature in the engine is almost 1600 degree centigrade. At that places, most of the either it may be iron or whatever, it may coefficient of expansion or compression, whatever, it may be very high. Whereas in high grade cast iron, coefficient of expansion, and it means whenever we heat any material, automatically expansion will be takes place. So here, even though here 1600 degree centigrade, expansion will be very less compared to other substance, other things. Okay. So next, cylinder block. So cylinder block is nothing but cylinder including with the water jackets. Already I told in water cooling system, entire cooling will be takes place by using the water jackets. And it means entire cooling will be entire heat will be absorbed by the water, that will be transmitted to the radiator. Okay. Next, cylinder head. See here, this is the cylinder. Okay, cylinder head will be 1 minute. So cylinder head having detachable portion. Okay, so whenever the heat is liberated, that cylinder head, entire heat will be generated at the cylinder head itself. Okay. Next, piston. So this is the piston. Already I told you, three grooves are available on the piston. Two for compression rings and one for oil ring. Compression rings are to utilize for the purpose of movement into the cylinder block, whereas oil ring is to scrap the entire oil which are available in the cylinder. Okay. So here one more thing is, one end of the piston is open. Here bottom portion will be open. Okay. That bottom portion is connected with the connecting rod with the piston pin. Already I told, piston pin also called as wrist pin or guardian pin. Okay. So next, so whenever the gas is, whenever gas is occurred, that gas will be moved towards downward direction by pushing this piston towards downwards. Okay. So one more thing, piston head and piston scud. So head is nothing but top portion of the piston pin, which are top portion of piston pin, from here to top portion, that is piston head. Whereas bottom portion, it is called skirt. Okay, piston head and skirt. Piston head also called as crown. Okay, so major aim of skirt is to observe the side movements. Whenever the piston move towards downward and upward direction, piston may have some side movements. So to reduce the skirt is utilized. Okay. Next, piston rings. Piston rings are made with the cast iron or pressed steel alloy. Cast iron or pressed steel alloy. Already I told, compression ring. What is the purpose of compression rings and oil rings? Okay. So here, see, to prevent the excessive oil consumption, okay, to control the distribution of lubrication oil and gap. One more thing here is 1 mm per 200 mm diameter. Let us take this diameter. Diameter is nothing but distance between these two, maximum distance. Okay, so if it is 200 mm, it means 20 cm. Diameter of the piston, there will be gap 1 mm. So that is standards, 1 mm for every 200 mm of diameter piston. Okay, if piston is 400 mm diameter, it means 40 cm diameter, then there will be 2 mm gap between two rings. Okay. So these are the piston ring and oil rings. So see, piston pin. piston pin also. Purpose of piston pin is to connect the piston with connecting rod. Okay, see here, this piston pin will be placed in this groove. Okay, so this is made with case hardened alloy steel. Next, connecting rod. So smaller end of the connecting rod is connected with the piston, whereas larger end is connected with the crankshaft. See here, this is the smaller end, it is connected with the piston. Okay, whereas this is the bigger end, it is connected with the crankshaft. Okay, so whenever power is occurred in the cylinder, that power will be transmitted towards flywheel by utilizing the piston and connecting rod. Okay, so connecting rod is connected made up of draft forged steel. Okay, so these are very important, which material, which component is made with the which material, those are very important. Okay, next, crankshaft. One more thing is, here is cylinders are moving topward direction and bottom direction, it means reciprocating motion, but our connecting rod is our crankshaft is rotating in rotary direction. Okay, so main this crankshaft is utilizing for converting the reciprocating motion into rotary motion. Okay, most of the times this bit will come as like this. Reciprocating, which material, which object is converting the reciprocating motion into rotary motion, that is crankshaft. Okay, it is made up with draft forged steel. Okay, and already I told, now one side there will be flywheel to absorb the entire energy in the power stroke, and during remaining idle strokes it will transmit the energy. Okay, see, this is the crankshaft of four cylinder engine. See here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is the four cylinder engine crankshaft. Okay, here connecting rod is connected with the here connecting rod will be attached with the crankshaft. Okay, another and a four cylinder now, so four connecting rods will be there, those four will be connected at here, one and here, here and here. Okay, so next, flywheel is made up of cast iron. So already I told so many times, it stores the energy during power stroke and it return back the same energy during the idle strokes. Idle strokes are nothing but suction, compression and exhaust strokes. Okay, and rear surface of the flywheel serves, that flywheel is connected with the clutch plate. Whenever we apply the clutch, so power will be shut down. Whenever release the clutch, that power will clutch will connected to the flywheel, then the power will transmitted to the transmission system. Okay, see, this is the flywheel. Next, crankcase. So bottom portion of the crankshaft, one of the sump crankcase will be there, that is nothing but a sump. In that, oil will be stored, it means lubrication oil. Some of the already I told you, almost 1600 degree centigrade temperature will be reduced by water cooling system. Some of the energy, some of the heat will be reduced by lubrication system also. Here, lubrication oil will be splashed on the surfaces of cylinder and piston. Okay, that entire lubrication oil will be scrapped with the oil ring. A scrapped oil will be stored in the sump. that is nothing but crankcase. Okay, entire lubrication oil will be placed in the crankcase. And one more thing, there will be oil pump, oil filter, dynamo and self motor on the surfaces of crankcase itself. It is made with the cast iron or cast aluminium. Okay, so this is the crankcase of cylinder. So bottom portion, here bottom portion there will be sump. Okay, this is the cylinder. Here piston will be moved towards the downward direction and upward direction. Okay, see here you are you observing crankshaft? So see here crankshaft is there. Okay, so next camshaft. What is the purpose of camshaft? Major purpose of camshaft is to operate the inlet and outlet valves. Okay, one end of the camshaft will have cam gear. That is nothing but a half time gear. Number of teeth in the cam gear are double number of teeth on the crank gear. Okay, generally crankshaft is driven with the gears. Already I told my gear, from crank gear to cam gear. Sometimes that is driven with chains. If the cam gear and crank gear distance is very high, and it means somewhat high, at that times chain will be utilizing to transmit the energy. And here I want to share one thing. So total drives are belt drive, gear drive and chain drive. Most effective drive is gear drive. Why? Because teeth are connected with the connected with each other. So automatically whatever energy transmitted with the driven gear, so drive gear, driven gear also rotate. Whereas in chain and belt there will be some slippage. Belt will have higher slippage compared to chain. Okay, so most effective drive is gear drive. Okay, next chain drive, most of the energy loss in the belt drives. Okay, so this is the camshaft. Okay, so these cams here, some higher elevation parts are there, na? These are utilizing for operating the inlet and outlet valves. So whenever this camshaft is rotating, so here valves are placed here. So automatically when it reaches to the bottom surface of valve, automatically that valve will rises upward direction. When it moves towards the downward direction, there will be plane here. Okay, automatically that valve will be placed into the downward direction. So next, timing gear. So one end of the cam gear, here one end of the cam gear, timing gear will be there. That is nothing but already I told the half time gear. Okay, see here, camshaft gear is bigger size than the crankshaft gear. It means twice number of teeth with respect to crank gear, crankshaft gear. Okay, so here timing gear controls the ignition, timing of opening of and closing valves. Already I told camshaft is utilizing for operating the inlet and outlet valves. So whenever inlet valve is open, air fuel mixture will be enter into the cylinder. Whenever outlet valve is open, burnt gases which are available in the cylinder, that will be moves outward direction. One more thing here is removal of burnt gases from the cylinder is called scavenging. One of the important bit, removal of burnt gases from the cylinder is called scavenging. Okay, so this is the crank gear and this is the cam gear. So let us take number of teeth in the crank gear is 10. There will be number of teeth in the cam gear is 20. Okay, next, inlet manifold and exhaust manifold. Nothing but if it is valve system, it is inlet valve. If it is ports, inlet manifold and outlet manifold. Inlet valve is nothing but whenever the camshaft is operated, inlet valve through inlet valve air fuel mixture will be enter into the cylinder. Okay. Next, exhaust valve is for removal of burnt gases. See here detailed parts. So this is the piston from here to here. This is the piston. Top portion of the piston is already at our crown. Okay. Bottom portion is called skirt. Okay. Here piston pin will be there. Piston pin also called as wrist pin or guardian pin. Here three grooves are available. Top two are compression rings and bottom one is oil ring. Oil ring already I told na, scraping of entire oil towards the sump. Okay, this is the connecting rod. So one end, smaller end is connected with the piston and bigger end is connected with the crankshaft. Here crankshaft will be there. Okay, one end of the crankshaft there will be a flywheel. Okay. See, already I explained this figure. Sir, Nayak sir, hello sir.
Ah, Harsha, is it over?
Sir.
Harsha, is it over?
Over sir. Can I give some more questions on this topic, sir?
Okay, you can. Continue.
So, thermal efficiency of external combustion engine. Sir, please on for all participants, sir. Audio. Hello. Hello.
They are texting in chat box, Harsha.
Okay, okay, sir. Sorry. Okay, thermal efficiency of external combustion engine.
Most of the people giving answer is 15 to 20%.
Okay, correct, sir. Next, thermal efficiency of internal combustion engine.
Answer given 3 people is answer given 4 people given 40%. C.
Okay, that is correct, sir.
Okay.
Please read once the statement. If the combustion cycle is completed with 2 revolution of crankshaft, then that engine is called. It means one power stroke occurred after completion of 2 revolution of crankshaft.
Mixed response is there. Some given A, some given B.
So here I want to explain about this question. See, this is very important. One power stroke, nothing but combustion cycle is nothing but a power stroke. Okay, completion with 2 revolution of crankshaft. So whereas in 2 stroke cycle engine, suction and compression will take place in a single stroke. It means single stroke means revolution of crankshaft will be only half. Okay, and in another stroke power and exhaust will be takes place. So one complete revolution in 2 stroke engine will get one power stroke, whereas in 4 stroke engine 2 complete revolution of crankshaft, then we will get only one power stroke. For this question, answer is 4 stroke engine. Okay, next, shall I go for next question?
Yeah, you can. Next, move.
Crankshaft RPM of medium speed engine.
Most of students given is 100 to 250 RPM.
100 to 250 is correct answer. And one more thing is, if crankshaft RPM is less than 100, then it is low speed engines. Whereas more than 250 RPM, it is high speed engines. Okay. Bottom portion of piston is called. Okay, C is skirt is correct answer. So whereas top portion of piston, so head and crown, both A and B is the correct answer. Head and crown. Okay. Source of power in engine. Okay, here one more time I have to remind, during power stroke whatever energy is produced, that energy will transmitted towards the flywheel through piston, from piston to connecting rod, connecting rod to crankshaft, crankshaft to flywheel, during the power stroke only. Okay, remaining strokes, which are suction, compression and exhaust, entire energy will transmitted from flywheel. Those three are the idle strokes. Only power stroke is the power, only single stroke which are generating the power. Okay, next.
Harsha, you can repeat once again.
So about this question, sir.
Previous one
means,
yeah, no this one only, power source.
Okay
sequence of power, the energy flow.
Okay, one more time I will remind. Okay, energy will be generating in the cylinder, that energy will transmitted towards flywheel by piston, connecting rod and crankshaft. Okay, first, sir, all are Telugu people?
Yes, sir, Telugu only.
Okay, so here, Chudma.
No, some of non-Telugu also is there.
Other language also there?
Other language
okay,
also
okay. There. Okay, sir. So whatever energy produced in the cylinder, that will transmitted to the flywheel. Then that flywheel is, energy is, 1 minute. Whatever energy produced in the cylinder is transmitted to the flywheel. In between cylinder and flywheel, we have piston, connecting rod and crankshaft. Okay, so energy in the cylinder will absorb by the piston. From piston, energy will transmitted to the connecting rod. From connecting rod, entire energy will transmitted to the crankshaft. One end of the crankshaft will have flywheel. That energy, most of the energy will absorb by flywheel. Okay, another end of the crankshaft will have crank gear. Okay, that crank gear is utilizing to revel rotate the cam gear. Already I told number of teeth in the crank gear is half of the teeth on cam gear. Okay, cam gear is utilizing to operate inlet and outlet valves. Okay,
so here answer is,
here answer is flywheel.
Flywheel,
that
is not, means that is consuming na energy.
Sorry, no sir, entire energy is absorbing by the flywheel,
means source of power in engine.
Yes sir.
Okay.
So entire energy is absorbed by the flywheel.
Okay,
that flywheel is connected with the clutch. So whenever clutch is pressed, flywheel and clutch plate will be disengaged.
Okay,
at that time we will operate the gear.
Okay,
either it may be first gear, second gear, whatever.
Okay,
whenever we release the clutch, that clutch plate will be attached with the flywheel. Flywheel already rotating in rotary direction. Okay, that will be connected with clutch plate. Those clutch plates are connected with the transmission system. So these entire energy moves towards the wheel through transmission system. Okay
then continue.
Next, connecting rod is made up of one of the very important bit. Okay, draft for the steel is correct answer. Whereas flywheel, please write in chat box. Flywheel is made up of cast iron. Removal of burnt gases from the cylinder is called. Yes, all are correct. Scavenging. Piston pin also called. Okay, correct sir. Next sir. Hello.
Okay Arshad, thank
sir,
you.
One minute sir.
Okay,
can I explain one more time about two stroke engine and four stroke engine? I think it is very important.
Okay you can.
Okay, so in four stroke engine, number of strokes are already in that suction stroke, compression stroke. So see, suction nothing but intake, compression power and exhaust. During the suction itself, so during the suction stroke, entire air fuel mixture will be enter into the cylinder. Okay, during the suction stroke, inlet valve will be open. So this inlet valve is open now. So air fuel mixture will be entering to the cylinder. Okay. After completion of suction stroke, compression will be takes place. So suction is from TDC to BDC. TDC is top dead center. BDC is bottom dead center. Okay. Distance between two. TDC to BDC is stroke length. Okay. So after completion of suction stroke, when it reaches to the bottom dead center, suction will be complete. Then it will move towards the upward direction. So compression will be takes place. Okay. So compression takes place means, so here area is very high compared to here. So automatically particle density is very less, whereas compared to here. So compression is there. So after completion of this compression stroke, this power will be ignited by spark plug. So just a small power will be ignited. So already it is compressed air fuel mixture. So whenever this fire is ignited, entire air fuel mixture will be burned. Okay, here power will be generate in the, this is the cylinder. Okay, power will be generate. That power causes the movement of piston towards downward direction. See this arrow mark. Okay, this piston moves towards the downward direction. Okay, so whatever energy produced here, that will transmitted through piston, connecting rod, crankshaft. One end of the crankshaft will have flywheel. That flywheel will absorb entire energy during the power stroke. Okay, next exhaust stroke. Some of the energy will be takes place in the cylinder itself. That will remove during the exhaust stroke. Okay, removal of burned gases from the cylinder is nothing but a scavenging. So during exhaust stroke, exhaust valve is open. Okay, whereas in two-stroke engine, so piston is at, first of all, piston is at top dead center. It will move towards the downward direction. At that time, the air fuel mixture will be moves into the cylinder. Then it will move towards upward direction. Compression will be takes place. So whenever it reaches to the top dead center, okay, spark plug will be ignite. Okay, that spark causes the total burning of air fuel mixture. That pushes the piston towards downward direction. Okay, at that time, if any burn gases is available, that will move towards exhaust ports. Okay, major difference in four stroke and two stroke inlet manifold and outlet manifolds are, in four stroke engine there will be valves, whereas in two stroke engine there will be ports. Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Harsha.
Thank you, sir.
You delivered a wonderful session on different type of engines and their working principle and its components. So, students, I hope you got learned something new. Whatever you know earlier, then something new or some new aspects regarding this different type of engines and explain two-stroke engine. Harsha, someone is asking, explain two-stroke engine.
Explain. Okay, okay, sir. Okay. So major difference in the four-stroke and two-stroke. Okay. One complete revolution of crankshaft. If we get one power stroke, that is two-stroke engine. Whereas in four-stroke engine, we are getting one power stroke by complete two revolution of crankshaft. So here two stroke engine. So during the suction stroke, suction means So during the suction, air fuel will be enter towards the cylinder. At that time only compression also takes place. Okay, so air fuel mixture will be enter into the cylinder as well as compression is takes place in single stroke. Okay, in second stroke, power and exhaust. So here power is ignited and exhaust also occurred in the single stroke when the piston is at top dead center. If piston is at top dead center, power stroke and exhaust strokes are occurring in single stroke. It causes the movement of piston towards downward direction. So can I explain one more time, sir?
Okay.
So during the suction and compression stroke, okay, this piston is a BDC. BDC nothing but bottom dead center. During the bottom dead center, air fuel mixture will be enter into the cylinder. At that time only this piston move towards the top dead center from BDC to TDC. Okay, here after completion of single stroke we are getting two works, suction and compression. Okay, when piston reaches to the TDC, spark plug is ignited. So when spark plug is ignited, entire air fuel mixture will be burned. At that time this piston move towards the downward direction due to that heat. Okay, from this piston will moves from TDC to BDC. Power and exhaust also occurred in single stroke, that is two stroke engine.
Okay, Harsha, there is one question from student.
Okay sir.
Which stroke engine generally used in tractor?
Tractor four stroke engines, sir.
Power tiller?
Power tiller also four stroke engines. Most generally these all are for high, and it means high capacity vehicles.
Okay.
Okay, for tractors these yeah. all are utilizing for farm purposes. So it requires higher energy with a diesel engines.
And another question, 1 hectare to till 1 hectare or 1 hectare area, 1 hectare land, how much power is required for tractor engine?
Sir, generally average in India 1.5 HP is recommended, but most of the tractors we are having 35 above tractors. Okay.
Question is to till 1 hectare area, how much power is required?
Maniki,
1 hectare area, 1 hectare land area.
Sir, we can till with 35 HP, 40 HP, whatever. So okay. It is depending upon the capacity. And for example, if it is 40 HP, we can okay. till up to subsurface. It means okay. subsoiling also we can do.
Okay.
We cannot provide 1.5 HP, 2.5 HP. It is very less.
Okay.
Okay. Averagely, 1.5 HP is required for operate 1 HP. Let us take 40 HP tractor. Okay. It can operate around 25 hectares of land. So for a single hectare of land, we can't provide smaller capacity 1.5 HP tractor. Na?
Okay.
Don't have any, even 1.5 means that is only for centrifugal pump capacity only.
Okay, which tractor engine is used in bikes?
Tractors?
Bikes. Engine type in bikes, two-wheelers.
Two-wheeler? Okay, in two-wheeler, petrol, two-stroke, four-stroke also available. In previous days, two-strokes also there. Yamaha RX-100 is there, na? That is two-stroke engine. Whereas in nowadays, those all are four-stroke petrol engines.
Okay, any more questions from student side?
So one more thing here is, previous time, TVS 50 is there, na? We are pouring 2T oil also. If any two-stroke engine is there, we need to provide 2T oil with petrol. But in modern bikes, we are not providing any 2T oil with the fuel. So that is four stroke. You can directly observe if we pour 2T oil, that is two stroke engine. Blindly you can go with that. Okay.
Okay. Any question from student side? Any more question? Student, you can interact. Okay, then thank you, Harsha. It's a very nice session, and thank you for giving this wonderful session. And our students also getting some new things about different type of engines and this farm power. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Then students, you try to. I am every time telling try to attend live classes whenever possible. Some of the students not joining the live classes. Mostly they are thinking that there is a videos. Anyhow, videos is available, but it's something different. Live classes something effective than video classes. Okay. Anyhow, we'll come back at 8 p.m. So now take some rest and if possible take some light dinner. Some light dinner and come back. Okay, our next session will start exactly at 8 p.m.